the jewel in the crown of prominent revolutionaries who sacrificed their everything for the nation's freedom struggle, Vinayak Damodar Savarkar. The post-independence era saw the propagation of selfish anti-Hindu politics, due to which the Indian society was denied the realization of true worth of Veer Savarkar's contribution. On the contrary, he was vilified for the assassination of Gandhi in independent India, at a time where he should have been awarded Bharat Ratna. Savarkar was at the receiving end of politically motivated hostility. This is indeed a grave insult of this heroic son of the soil. Savarkar was held guilty of three charges: treason, act of war against the British, and assisting in the murder of British officer Jackson. Vinayak Savarkar is the only freedom fighter in the world to be sentenced to two life imprisonments. That is 50 years. At this time, all his earnings were also seized. He was sent to the cellular jail in Andaman. Savarkar underwent extreme physical and mental torture in the prolonged nightmarish period of 10 years between July 4, 1911 and May 2, 1921. An ordinary human being would have accepted death instead. However, Savarkar could return alive from Andaman owing to his strong mental strength and determination. The incident of his return from Andaman recently marked 100 years. A recount of the atrocities on Savarkar in Andaman will send shivers down anybody's spine. The rice gruel given to the prisoners in Andaman for breakfast would reek of kerosene. The vegetables served for lunch would contain pieces of centipedes and even snakes. Half-cooked rice and half-cooked or burnt breads being forced to eat while standing outside even in heavy rains. In Andaman, Savarkar would be given the extremely physically taxing work of making rope by beating coconut husk. Savarkar and few other prisoners would be tied to the ghana, a wooden unit to extract oil from coconut using bulls as a substitute to the bulls. They would be forced to extract 30 pounds of coconut oil every day, and failure to do so would attract severe punishment. The inferior quality and quantity of food and harsh physical exertion gave Savarkar life-threatening diseases like dysentery and malaria. Savarkar never wrote a letter of apology to the British. By around 1920, nationwide petitions and protests for Savarkar's release had gained momentum. These activities never received the participation of Gandhi and Nehru. Finally, the British government bowed down to the public pressure and released Savarkar from Andaman. That day was May 2, 1921. Then, he and his brother Baba Rao were moved to a jail in Ratnagiri of today's Maharashtra. This unimaginable sacrifice made by Veer Savarkar for the nation cannot be matched. A humble salutation to Veer Savarkar on behalf of all Hindus. Let us all take inspiration from his fervent nationalism and in our capacity work tirelessly towards the mission of establishing Hindu Rashtra. This will prove to be a fitting tribute to him in the real sense on behalf of every Indian.
विभाजित होकर भी ये देश अनेक अर्थों में एक जीव, एक राष्ट्र, एक छत्र बन गया है। केवल सिंधु नदी ही इससे अलग हुई है। जब तक एक भी हिंदू जीवित है, हम उसे नहीं भूलेंगे। इस दुनिया में यदि हमें हिंदू राष्ट्र के नाते स्वाभिमान से जीवन जीना है, तो उसका हमें पूरा अधिकार है, और वो राष्ट्र हिंदू राष्ट्र के नाम से स्थापित होगा, इस पीढ़ी में नहीं तो अगली पीढ़ी में मेरी यह महत्वाकांक्षा अवश्य सत्य सिद्ध होगी। यदि वो गलत साबित हुई तो मैं पागल कहलाऊंगा, और सत्य सिद्ध हुई तो लोग मुझे दृष्टा कहेंगे। मैं अपना ये उत्तराधिकार तुम्हें सौंप रहा हूं।